We're going to try to answer a simple question. How do all of these giant magnets and other massive components fit together to make a tokamak? We'll use this simplified model. It's actually a 3D printed model drawn directly from the ITER CAD drawings, the computer drawings, created for us by Tamás Jabolik and Márton Vavrik of the Hungarian Centre for Energy Research. Thank you both very much. Tomorrow we will upload these 3D printed files directly on the ITER public website, so that anyone, any student, any teacher can use these as an educational tool. So yes, you can make your own tokamak. It will be a little bit smaller than the ITER tokamak. It will be 1/100th in scale. So if the ITER tokamak is 30 meters high, 30 meters in diameter, this will be 30 centimeters high, 30 centimeters in diameter. But you can use this in your classroom, in your makerspace, or even if you're a fan, print it out in the privacy of your own home and follow along with us during ITER assembly phase. Now, to talk about the tokamak, the parts that we've removed here first are part of the ITER cryostat. It acts like a thermos, and it creates a vacuum, a cool, clean environment for the rest of the tokamak to operate in, and it's manufactured in India. Then, by removing it, you see inside here this donut-shaped chamber, plasma chamber, the vacuum vessel. And the ITER vacuum vessel is where we will inject the hydrogen gas and heat it to become a plasma, so that we can create fusion energy at 150 million degrees Celsius. There are 9 vacuum vessel sectors. We have removed 2 of them here so that you can see inside. And these are manufactured half in Korea and half in Korea, 5 in Europe. At the bottom, you can see this diverter. The diverter is, it actually acts like a sort of giant exhaust system. This is where we will collect the helium ash and the other impurities using large pumps and extract that from the vacuum vessel. Now, to explain the ITER magnets, we have 3 systems. The first one is the circular magnets, the poloidal field coils, ring-shaped. These are what Dr. Bigot was just showing you on the ITER worksite. So the smallest one, procured by Europe, manufactured in China, is here at the bottom. And then the other small one here is being made now in St. Petersburg in Russia. The rest of these are too large to ship, so they are being made here in Europe. And they help to create the magnetic cage and to push the plasma away from the walls, pinch it away from the walls. Together with these blue ones, the D-shaped toroidal field magnets, and the blue ones, there are 18 of these, the blue ones, that are actually made in half in Japan, half in Europe. And together with these 6 poloidal field magnets, they create an invisible magnetic cage inside the steel vacuum vessel chamber. They also are assisted by this central solenoid, the one shown in green. This is ITER's most powerful magnet. It is made in 6 independent modules in the United States. And in addition to helping create the cage, it twists the flux lines of the magnetic field and drives a long sustained current through the plasma. Now, that explains overall what we've got here. And I will say just this week, the first vacuum vessel sector, combined with these port stubs from Russia, arrived in the Marseille harbor, and this is what will allow us to begin actually adding the toroidal field coils, the thermal shield, and assembling the ITER vacuum vessel. So, there are of course many other pieces, more than 1 million components overall in the ITER tokamak, but this now has given you hopefully a general understanding of how we are going to use magnetic confinement fusion to create fusion energy in the ITER tokamak.